12th, I believe. And the tractor and trailer load of straw you see in front is second from last load to go into the holding yard. And the very last one is on my back. I've got exactly the same on the back of me. I've got 53 Heston bales on, and he's got 53 Hestons on. So this is the last run of the season hauling straw in. Everything now is in the holding yard, back a little over.
Triaxle, and he's been bale carting with me.
it has been pulling lovely. They're doing a lovely little job. You know, I've used it a bit, and I have got a bit used to the steering now, which is a help. And we've got Mr. Gates coming the other way. He's on a potato car. Well, it's one of his blokes. But, no, the little class area has done well. I've used her a few times now. Still the gearbox isn't great, and it's still lurches when you put the brakes on and it bounces like a pigging ball. But after saying that, it ain't too bad. She's got a bit of heart in her. But yeah, she's got a bit of heart to her. And yeah, the seat, the scissor action on the seat's all worn, so Olivers are very kindly fitting a new scissor action on the seat. This is the thing about Olivers, they're bloody good company. New scissor action on the seat, and radiator's got a leak, so they're putting a new radiator on it for me as well. So I'm really very, very pleased. I'm going to piss these people off. In a hurry. Thank you. See, that's why they don't like farmers. Lovely is if I don't go, I'll sit there for a half hour waiting. And he's probably on his lunch break anyway, because what's the time? Where's my clock? 2 o'clock. 2:02. We're just think somebody bit them all at me. No, a little tractor, a little class tractor. Yeah. Growing on me. I don't mind driving in the field, but I don't like driving up the road. Like I said, it's like sitting on a poxy pogo stick. But, yeah. Bit upset with JCB. They're not giving us the support we need with these tractors. We've had a little bit of an issue with an overheating gearbox on a 7270. And it took us nearly 3 days to get any help from JCB specialists. And that was Oliver's trying to get it. So, yeah, we needed a few bits. And it was a bit upsetting that you couldn't get the bits, neither. LCS used to look after my lorries for me. The gearbox has to run at a certain temperature, so they put a thermostat in the flow of the oil system for the gearbox to get the heat up in the gearbox. When it gets to a certain temperature, this thermostat opens and lets the oil go through the cooler. But to begin with, it just circulates in the gearbox to get the heat up. And what happens is the thermostat closes to make the oil go to the cooler. And it wasn't closing, it's a backwards-frontwards thermostat. It wasn't closing, so it was just putting the oil around the gearbox and overheating the oil. Overheating the oil, so that was a little bit annoying. So, but we had a calibration problem to start with. It took me 3-4 days to sort that out, and then we've had this overheating oil problem. I've had to put some special synthetic oil in the gearbox. Cost me 45 litres, cost me £480 for oil. I won't moan about engine oil price ever again. Steve went out with it this morning for the first time with his new thermostat in. I haven't heard anything, so no news is good news at the minute. down there, Snetterton Power Station, put that on YouTube, and they've uploaded a promotional film of the power station, so you'll be able to actually see the cranes and everything that unload me. So there you go, that's worth a look. Right, we're coming up the A1, no, we're going down the A1 towards Sandy. About to come up to John's Bridge, Frontier, that's one of the main grain buyers in the area, merchants or whatever you want to call them. I get me sprays, me seed corn from there, and I sell them my seed corn.
We've got traffic lights here.
we go through, they're fucked up again. These traffic lights keep going bloody wrong. They keep going wrong. Go on, mate, you sit there, something's going to come the other way.